Hello everyone! In this video we will show you one of the results of Safelayer's research activities, the Semantic Digital Signature. This video focuses on a particular use case where the Semantic Digital Signature is used to sign a résumé, also known as CV, after curriculum vitae, in order to guarantee the document's integrity as well as its source. Since 2002, the World Wide Web Consortium has been working on standards for the new web generation, the Semantic Web. The main Semantic Web standards are RDF after Resource Description Framework and OWL after Web Ontology Language, both based on XML. So, in the beginning we had XML, the Extensible Markup Language, which was a first step to easily tag information and include metadata in documents. For example, with this piece of XML we could describe some identity attributes of a person identified as John. In particular, we could use a few simple XML tags to include his full name and his birth date. Resource Description Framework is an evolution of XML and is based on the idea of making statements about resources, following a triple structure. A subject has got a property that takes some value. So, after the example shown here, we could say that John is a person and John's name is John Smith. In fact, the main goal of these new semantic standards is to provide a better way to describe and model information and help building vocabularies, the so-called ontologies, which can be used to write semantic information that can be later automatically processed by machines and also better understood by humans in respect to traditional XML. Following RDF and with the purpose of providing a language to describe ontologies, emerges OWL, the Web Ontology Language. OWL allows us to describe vocabularies better, establishing richer relationships and properties. In this example, OWL would help us to declare a simple ontology, where we would restrict the properties that the class person may have, as a name, a date of birth, a city of birth, and so on, as well as the data types of these properties. Therefore, with OWL, we may state what the concept person means in a very accurate way. Among all these vocabularies, one of the most popular is FOV, the friend of a friend ontology, which is used to describe information about a person. FOV was created to describe friendship relationships. That's why it has become a very useful vocabulary now that social network applications are so popular. With FOV, we can describe a person, and as it is a very open ontology, we can include as many other vocabularies as we wish in order to describe any other different aspects of his or her life. For example, we could include his professional career with the DOAC ontology. An example of FOV document could then be a resume that would describe job experiences, skills and education, among others. So, here we have John who is writing his resume, and now he wants to sign it in order to provide it with some integrity and authenticity. Integrity is the property that allows to check that the document has not been modified after it was signed, and authenticity is the property that allows to verify who the author of the document was. In order to sign his resume, John can use the traditional digital signature. To sign his resume, John can choose any digital signature application, such as Safelayer's OpenSignX or Q1 Desktop. However, traditional digital signature has some limitations. If John updates the document or adds new pieces of information in it, the signature loses all its value and will no longer be valid. For instance, if he wants to add a new professional experience, he will have to sign the whole document again after making any modifications on it, despite the importance and the extent of the modification. Moreover, when it comes to trust, the trustworthiness of the information stated in the document equals the same trust you put in John. That is to say, you trust in the whole content of the document as long as you trust John. At Safelayer, we have designed the Semantic Digital Signature, a new type of digital signature based on Semantic Web Standards, specially designed to solve the previous issues. In this case, the digital signature is expressed in RDF standard, and not in a simple XML format like traditional XML digital signature. Our semantic signature implementation works as follows. As in traditional digital signature, John writes his resume. The information in the document is diverse, and among others, we can find personal information, information about his education or his job experiences and interests. The idea upon semantic signature is that these bits of information contained in the document can be signed by the different third parties which are accountable for them. That is to say, the information will not be signed directly by John, but by some organizations who can endorse that information. The final objective is that people who read John's resume are able to check that the information is trustworthy beyond John's word. So, for instance, John's resume contains his complete name, his ID number, and his address, and this information can be endorsed by a public administration that has this information on its records, and therefore can state that the information is true with the signature. Another section of John's resume is education. John attendance to high school or universities can be certified by these educational institutions, who will sign the bits of information related to John's education. In fact, this piece of signed information would have the same value as the physical diploma given to John by the university when he graduated. And that applies also to the organizations where John has worked, and whose human resources department can confirm that John worked for them as well as the tasks he used to perform. So, in the end, John can write his resume as he used to do, but with semantic digital signature, different third parties can endorse the resume's content, resulting in a set of different signatures and turning the document into a trustworthy resume. This can be achieved because semantic signature is not static like traditional digital signature, in a way that you can make some changes and still not affect the integrity of the whole document. As you are not signing an entire document, you don't need to renew the signature, but instead, you just have to sign the particular bit of your resume and add the new signature. Technically, the document will be updated with a new set of references in order to verify the new information. Semantic signature also provides more trust to the information contained in the resume, because each piece of the information is signed by the entity who is accountable for it. Feel free to try Semantic Digital Signature at sandbox.safelayer.com. An implementation of our Semantic Digital Signature is available at FOF Manager and PKI Trust Center experimental applications.